Hello and welcome back to the Beltgrinder build. A link to the previous episode can be seen up in the corner. So far I've made the base, I'm using an old front fork, and I've made some legs out of square pipe. Let's jump right into the next step, which is the front plate, the front face. To have something to fasten the front plate to, I decided to weld a plate to the pipe. And to make it a bit easier for me to weld the plate in place, I made a cut in the pipe so I could insert the plate into the cut.
The idea is to fasten this one here. This surface will be the support behind the sanding belt. I want the holes so that I can tilt this 45 degrees. Designed and 3D printed these rolls. They're designed to have a bearing at each end. I didn't design them with a straight surface, so it's slightly curved, which helps aligning the belt to the middle of it and helps prevent the belt from sliding off it. I'm gonna fasten this hinge, and this roll is gonna be on the bottom part. And if you then put a screw on here, you could slightly adjust the angle of it, which will also help keep the belt from sliding off. Since I like the idea of building with what I have, which I think spurs the imagination, I had these bearings, but they have 8mm diameter hole. I haven't got an M8 screw of the needed length. What I have is M6, so I have 2mm gap, and then is why I 3D printed these cylinders to try and bridge the gap. We'll see if they break or move. The cylinders are a lot wider than the backplate, so I'm gonna have to prolong it a bit. But I think I'm gonna try with a belt first, so learn a bit more, then do that. I will weld that disc onto this shaft after I cut it from the ring. Then I'm gonna weld everything to the back end of my fork. Thank you.
I add some more square pipes to the base to compensate for the mass center, which ends up quite far back since the motor is the heaviest part of the construction. These are the components that will make up the table. I have two pieces of square pipes and two square rods. And then I have this ugly piece of plate. But I'm gonna try and use it anyway because I don't have anything better. I try to fill these depressions with some weld. And then I will grind it off and see if I can get a relatively clean, relatively smooth surface. I got a nut to the side of the square pipe so I can use the screws to lock the table in place. Not a perfect result. I think I'm gonna leave it like this for now, and maybe I will add some more weld and do some more grinding later on. In the next episode, we'll actually see the results. It's going to be all about belt tension, belt adjustments, fine-tuning, making some adjustments, testing, blah blah blah. If you enjoyed the content, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe to not miss it. If you have some thoughts, don't hesitate to comment down below. Have a nice day.